Hi everyone and welcome back. Welcome to this ReactJS playlist. And in this video, we are going to build a simple application. Simple application can be simple as simple to-do application. Okay. And with that application, we will try to understand React, state, props, event binding. Okay. How the re-rendering is happening when the state is getting changed. Okay. How to manage a state, how to write a DOM events, how to update a state in the DOM event, how to bind this object to the DOM events, okay? So it is going to be a few set of videos like 1 and 2. We will just look at this to-do application, we'll try to see how to write it, and we will understand lot many concepts out of it, okay? So this is the kind of application we were already writing, so we'll just try to refactor it or just try to clean it. What we are doing is we have a header, we have an input, okay? So from this input text field, what you are doing is whatever you are typing, we are actually calling this handle change method, and this handle change is taking care of that, right? Here we can have one button, add new to do. Okay, this add new to do is actually updating the state, and whenever the state is getting updated, we are actually passing that state to the child component. Okay, till now we talked about only passing the data to the child component. Have we ever thought about, can we also splice the data? Can we also emit an event from child component to parent component that will be updating the state of the parent component, right? So what we can do is we simply have the list of items here. We'll extend it in the different ways. So to-dos is just a list of items and it is already working, right? Now what we will try to do is, let's say you add a to-do and there is also one button which is a delete button. Right, so with that delete button you should be able to delete a particular to do also from the list. Currently if you just try to see this how it is working, then we can see add task, this is working fine, right? Now what if I wanted to have a delete button here where I can just say mark, okay, delete, and this item is deleted from there, right? For that, where are we rendering this component? In the to do list component. Okay, before going there to the child component, we can see how we are managing the state. We have to-dos and task. Task is getting updated whenever you are typing something, and when you click onto this button, this is getting added in the to-do list. So we are actually getting one more array index, and here we are updating it, right? So there are many ways of writing this dot set state, which you will see. So this dot set state, if you see the signature of this function, it is taking callback function, right? So it can be something like this, the previous state, or you can put anything, last state, I mean the previous state, and based on the previous state, what I wanted to do is do something here. I will be updating the new state with that, right? This is my to-dos, and what I'm doing is previous state. So this is the previous state. Last state dot to do's, and here you can directly like concat, push, all these things you can do. So this is an array, concat this dot state dot text. This is also a way to do the same thing. Here we are doing it in the right way. I'm accessing the previous state, let's call it as a previous state. I mean that look better, right? Previous state means we have a previous state to do's and now we are concatting something new there, right? This is also a way of writing, or you can just simply write whatever you wanted to do it. But the right way of maintaining the immutability, you are not doing any changes, you are returning the new state. So you always update something based on what current previous state you have. So I'm getting the current, whatever the previous state is, and I'm updating on top of it, okay? We have a to-dos and task. Now, what we are going to have in the to-dos list, what we are getting is, we have index, right? Now, consider that here also you have one button, okay? It's not the right place, but let's see, you have one button, and in this button, you have onClick button, onClick action. This onClick action will actually update the state of parent component, but here I don't have a state. What I will be doing is I will be sending this event to the parent component, okay, then only I will be able to update the state. So what I can do is I have the index, okay, which particular item I need to update, right? So what I will do is I can just access this index and I will send it in a particular method. So here I can just say index arrow function, and this is a class based component, this dot remove item, okay, and I will pass this index, okay. So this remove item we are defining in the same component, when you say any method name with the prefix this means this method is defined here only, but whenever you see something coming as a props, this dot props, that means you are actually going to emit this event to the parent component. And what I'm doing is this dot props dot remove item, and I'm passing index whatever I'm getting from this method. So what I want is I will be emitting one event and I will sending that event to the parent component. So now what I'm doing is, in a simple language, I may be having constructor. Let's have this. Okay, and here you can have some kind of a state. This dot state. Every component can have a state. Added. I mean, you can say completed. Or you can say done is false. Initially, every to do item is not done. But when you click on it, right, when you are clicking on to this button, what I'm saying is, okay, this particular item is done. So I will also be doing one more thing is this dot set state, okay, PR previous state I have, and after that I will be doing done as, so this is the done, I will be just toggling this dot, okay, this previous state we already have. Done, right? So what I'm doing is, in the previous state I'm accessing done. If it is a true, then I'm making that false. If it is false, then I'm making true. Just for an example, nothing much. So when you click on to this delete, I will be getting this as a false. Okay, you can still keep these. So in that case you need to have a two attribute, the task name and the label and the flag if it is done or not. So I'm just trying to show it just for an example, that you can also have the state in your child component. Here we don't have a use case of keeping it, so I'm calling this remove item. Actually I deleted this also. So what remove item will be doing is, it will be calling one method to the parent component. So thumb rule, whenever you see this dot props dot something, that means you are actually trying to call the parent component method. When you see this dot method, it means this method is defined in the same component. So here I'm this dot remove item, it is defined in the same component. But here this dot props, it means we are going to call one parent component method. Actually we are accessing the property of parent component remove item. And here this is my remove item. And here also I have added this dot remove item. Remove item you can bind to this object. Bind with this object, right? Now I can define the remove item in the parent component, and I'm getting index from the child component. We'll just try to see alert if we are getting it or not. Okay, remove item, we are getting this remove item from the child component. So now you need to understand how components talk to each other. We are sending some data, component can also emit an event when switch some data. And with that event, when we are capturing that event at the parent component, we can update the state. We can do whatever we want. So this is a to-do list child component. Okay. On every li, we have one button. I mean, this is not the right way of writing HTML button inside li. So on click, when you click onto that button, here we can say that delete. Right. So here you can see to-do list item, and we are calling remove item, and in the to-do list we are actually getting this task in the props, okay, and here we are iterating on to that and we are actually having one button, right? So when you click on to delete, we have to emit an event. So we are calling this remove item method, right? And in this remove item, we can actually call this dot props dot remove item. This is actually a parent component method which we are accessing, and we are passing the index again here. Okay, now how it is working? From the app.js, you are exposing two properties. You are sending tasks and remove item, right? Task is having the list of tasks, and remove item is actually a function which you are sending to the child component. Now child component can trigger it. So there are two things we already talked about. If you see this dot props means some parent component property or parent component callback method. So remove item is defined in the parent component. Here you can see this dot remove item. Remove item, I have done the bind, and here I'm accessing the index, right? We'll just try to print what index we are getting from the child component. From this, we will understand, okay, how the child component can send data to the parent component for triggering some action. Right now, if you click on delete, we are getting index one, right? Add task, there are three items. You click on it, you are getting two. Right, so we are getting the index on the parent component. This is what we need. Once we get the index, rest of all the other things we can do. We get the index here in the remove item. So what we can do is we can actually splice that particular data from the items. So what we can do is here we got the index. So we can just simply list this dot state dot to do's we have. Okay, this is the list we have. We will just splice the one index, one element from this index, and we are again that setting the to-dos to the to-dos which we have got, right? We are just using destructuring, so we are just setting that to-dos here. Otherwise you can also write to-dos, but there is, it's not making any sense. You can use object shorthand. So we are setting to-dos here. You can say it is a to-do list. Just for our comfort, we just splice on it, and we are setting to-dos with to-do list. To-dos is an actual array. Now, you can reload it. This is gone, right? This is gone. So we are able to delete it, right? So this is how we have written a simple to-do application. What we have written is, first we have looked at these event binding, right? So whatever the DOM event we are writing in this, we have to actually bind it explicitly with this object, handle change, right? This handle change we have to do, bind it explicitly, or otherwise what you can do is you can do a dot bind with this object if you don't want it to do it there. This is the another way. Handle change. Similarly for remove item, add to do, you can also bind it explicitly here. There are different ways. Or you can use arrow function. This is for add new to do. And remove item we are actually getting from the child component. So you can also directly bind remove item here. This is the one way. Okay. There are other ways also, you can actually write an arrow.